what's about to happen next will really shock you. And I'm not talking about Bitcoin's actual price, whether, you know, people are saying it's going to go all the way to 100K before any correction, or if this is going to lead to a major crash right away. None of those are really that predictable at the first time that Bitcoin hits all-time high. But really, what is very, very apparent from previous cycles is that we are about to have a major altcoin season just a few weeks shortly after the Bitcoin new all-time high. So I'll show you guys all of the data points from last cycle when Bitcoin first hit its $20,000 new all-time high back in late 2020. All of the top altcoins back in those days show real charts that prove this. So we'll get into that today, and I'll also show you what I expect for Bitcoin's price based on the current institutional flow from the Bitcoin ETFs, as well as how this cycle has played out really early based on where Bitcoin's price is at right now compared to the upcoming Bitcoin halving event, which tells us we're actually leading a bit compared to previous cycles. And last but not least, we'll also get into some of my top altcoin picks if this alt season does indeed get triggered by the new all-time high. Then what are the top altcoins I'm paying attention to? So without further ado, if you guys are new here to the channel, welcome. My name is Dennis. I'm a crypto angel investor for the past 5 years, and I have invested in over 100 crypto companies. On this channel, I share my views on market trends and investing strategy to build wealth in crypto. Okay, so let's get into it. If you guys have any questions, please leave them down in the chat and in the comments, and we'll get through them at the very end. So right away, I want to show you guys the charts I'm looking at for today. Where is my browser? Here, let me get this up. Here we go. Okay, so so Bitcoin this morning has hit 63,600. Pretty crazy number if you think about it. Let me move myself to the right. And this is not just some short-term speculation, right? So first of all, the institutional flow is real. So we have covered this in our live stream last month, where after the Bitcoin ETF has been approved, the real institutional flow has indeed been positive, right? So from all the top 10 players of the Bitcoin ETFs that trade on TradFi markets, you know, just last month, we have seen a total net flow of 1.64 billion, right? This was as of February 5th. Now, it's really interesting if we revisit that number today, because the total net flow since February 5th has grown by more than $5 billion. So today, the net flow sits at $6.7 billion of new money coming into crypto through these Bitcoin ETFs. And this is in a matter of 3 weeks, right? So within 3 weeks, there has been a net of $5 billion of new money that has come into Bitcoin alone through these ETFs. And multiple sources track these and all agree, right? We have a Dune Analytics dashboard, which directly track the on-chain addresses of all of these ETFs. And you see this has also grew to 6.27 billion. So no matter how you look at it, the flows are positive. And again, we can look at really what has been happening in February, which is that most of the days there has been large inflows, right? So even though in January we were still settling some of the potential outflows that we've seen with Grayscale, right? So you see on the left here, these purple negative flows, outflows, came from Grayscale. But in February, those are pretty much all gone, and it has been completely overshadowed by the large inflows. And that's what we see on the black charts over here. So on average, right, most of the days we are seeing net flows of $500 to $600 million coming into these Bitcoin ETFs. So that explains a lot. That really explains why Bitcoin is moving up. Like that's just clear as day, right? So another really cool thing to see on today's chart is that not only is it the inflows, but the trading volume has also saw a new high. So in today's Bitcoin ETF market in general, the new nine ETF that's traded in the US TradFi markets, we have seen a total of $6 billion of trade volume for today with IBIT. I believe this is BlackRock's fund, BlackRock's ETF, leading with $3.3 billion of daily trading volume. Now, this has already doubled, right? This has doubled from yesterday's trade volume, and this volume also has peaked above the first day of trading volume when the spot ETFs launched on January 10th, right? So this is another very healthy sign to see. The trading volume matches the inflows. Data is all there. Real demand is coming in. Okay, now, is this really the time to say, okay, like retail is happening and, you know, new retail adoption is coming in? That part, I don't really think so yet. Because when we look at, okay, what are the trading interests, what are the kind of speculation interests among people that we talk to every day and people that we talk about in the industry, we aren't seeing that narrative yet, right? Unless you have been paying attention to all of these developments for the past year, you're still talking to the same people, right? You're not talking to new people necessarily about what's happening in crypto, even though these trade flow is there. So what's really happening right now, what I feel like, is that the institutions are front running the retail adoption. And this is also quite apparent when we get into the Bitcoin halving charts and what usually happens for Bitcoin price leading up to the halving. And that really explains why this time around, we're seeing a potential new all-time high even before the Bitcoin halving happens. So let's get into that. When we look at the Bitcoin halving events in history, right? So the most important chart is to look at is this. So this is what they call the rainbow chart that gives color codes to Bitcoin based on how close we are to each halving event, right? So you see at the last halving event in May 2020, right? This was when Bitcoin has just gone through not only a bear market, but also a significant black swan event. And then once the halving ticked over, right, Bitcoin really stopped to have any major, you know, downward shifts and started to slowly accelerate towards the upside. And then when we look at the 2016 halving, very similar, right? So Bitcoin did not hit a new all-time high, right, before the halving happened. So the previous all-time high in 2013 cycle was $1,100, and Bitcoin only hit about $780 and then even went a little bit below before the Bitcoin halving actually happened. And then finally, about 6 months after the halving, we have a new all-time high come in. So this type of pattern really repeats even back in the 2012 halving, right? You see, all-time high back then was around $30, halving happened, and then that is about 5 months after the halving, we had a new all-time high. So the last three cycles have all played out this way, right? You see 2020, again, new all-time high was at $20,000. Bitcoin hit its halving, and then about 6 months in, right, in November 2020, when we get out of this color-coded stage in orange, that's usually when the all-time high comes in. So this time around, we're seeing something very different because the Bitcoin halving event is yet to come, right? We're looking at April 24th to 27th this year. So we're still 1.5 months away, 50 days away, yet Bitcoin is already inching towards the previous all-time high at $68,000, right? So we're within 7-8% away. So this again shows that, okay, market is clearly maturing and people know that as long as the Bitcoin halving is happening, as long as the supply cut the inflation cut is happening, the stock to flow and the supply and demand mechanics will play out. And that's what I believe is necessarily why the institutions are front running this. And that is why we're seeing this significant run up even before the halving happens. Now, does this mean that Bitcoin is likely to go to, you know, what people are speculating now? Oh, it's going to shoot straight to 70, 80K, even 100K. I think that's highly unlikely, right? Just based on previous data, once we really take over and really get the retail involved, after the halving event happens, that's when we're going to have the majority of the bull run. So I think even if, you know, we do see maybe $68,000, even $70,000 within the next 1 to 2 months, I think we're very likely to just remain around this range and continue to chop, right? Instead of having something really crazy pre-halving. So that's my opinion based on the last three cycles. Again, what will the institutions do? We don't really know. If we continue to see day after day, right, new inflow, and pay attention to these inflow charts, right? You can go on socialvalue.xyz. They have these charts, or you can go on Dune Analytics. Just search for Bitcoin ETF, and you'll see these inflows. Now, if these inflows continue to be positive and even make new high inflows, right? Let's say we start to see on average $700-800 million of daily inflows, then maybe that's just how it is. Maybe I'll have to change my mind about this when that happens. But I suspect we are going to calm down a bit post this, you know, touching the previous all-time high crates. I think that's really what we're seeing right now. So that's my view on what's about to happen on Bitcoin's all-time high run. I think we should be able to touch it, but I don't think we're going to go much higher in the short term. Now, that is not shocking, right? Like that's basically saying not much. I know what people will think. Oh, like you're saying, you know, just be careful. Of course, that's, I think, the most rational thing to say here, most rational thing to do. Remain spot exposure, of course, but don't get too carried away ahead of ourselves. That's what I'm doing. Now, what I do think will be very shocking once Bitcoin hits its all-time high and starts to cool down is that the altcoin market will start to have some really big shock waves. So this is the meat of today's episode that I really want to show you guys. So I have brought up the historical charts of the most popular altcoins. Here is the list of them from when Bitcoin hit its last all-time high in 2020. So December 16th, 2020 was when Bitcoin hit its last all-time high of $20,000, right? In the new cycle. So this is talking about previous all-time high of $20,000 in January 2018, and then the second time that it revisited that all-time high in December 2020. So look at the list of top altcoins here, right? So we have Ethereum, XRP, we have Chainlink, Cardano, Polkadot, Binance Coin. And then I also threw in some really popular altcoins such as like Rune, Polkadot, Avalanche, which we knew that hit super, super large returns in that cycle. So what were these altcoins at and what were their price patterns post Bitcoin new all-time high? Okay, so let's get into it. So here is the chart of them on the right side here with the list. And let's first get into Bitcoin dominance. So Bitcoin dominance really tells us how Bitcoin is doing relative to the rest of the market, right? So whenever Bitcoin dominance rises very sharp, it means that Bitcoin is leading the market and the rest of the altcoin market is falling against Bitcoin, at least in ratio, right? So they're lagging behind Bitcoin. So when we match this with previous Bitcoin all-time high revisits, right? I'm going to do a compare chart and let's move this to the top And let's make this blog. Here we go. So the previous time that Bitcoin has hit its all-time high, new all-time high, right? Right around here, right? You see right here? So here is when it touched the previous all-time high at 20,000. What happened to Bitcoin dominance, right? So take a look at this. On this date and right around this 1 to 2 week period, Bitcoin dominance chart on the bottom here, it saw a significant rise, right? Where Bitcoin dominance actually grew by 10% within that month, right? So the months that Bitcoin has hit its all-time high, Bitcoin really led the market for that month. But you see what happened directly after that. That really kickstarted essentially the huge alt season that we saw in 2021, right? So Bitcoin dominance rose by 10%, but then dropped by, what is this, 40%, right? That's pretty crazy to see, right? So this was, if you're experienced in the market, you remember this, and you know what I'm talking about here. This was the period where as long as you bet on a leading, you know, new altcoin, you made a huge amount of profit from January 2021 to about May 2021. So this directly correlated to the few weeks after the last Bitcoin all-time high. Okay, so that's Bitcoin dominance. Let's look at some real examples. So Ethereum, not the best example because Ethereum is really not so much of an altcoin anymore. It usually just follows the pattern of Bitcoin. So this is why we see on Ethereum's chart, when Bitcoin hit 20,000 back in December 2020, right? Ethereum pretty much followed suit, right? Bitcoin run up, Ethereum run up. Okay, so we know that Ethereum is a good bet directly, which is always why I hold Bitcoin and Ethereum together. What are the other top altcoins that saw huge gains in early 2021? Here's the historical snapshot, right? So Chainlink, Cardano, Polkadot, Binance Coin, Avalanche, Solana, Matic. If you bet on any of those on January 1st, 2021, you saw huge growth, right? So let's bring them up. So we have, first of all, Polkadot. I know what you're thinking, like, oh, why are we talking about Polkadot? Polkadot was the hottest altcoin from January 2021 to summer 2021. We see this on the chart, right? So here, January 2021, until summer 2021, Polkadot went on, look at this, 8x gain in that 5 months period on this bottom chart here. And you see what triggered that, really, right? December 2020, Bitcoin hits new all-time high of $20,000. And then just about 3 weeks after that, right, Polkadot didn't see much. Right, Polkadot remained pretty quiet. People kind of likely gave up. A lot of people said, oh yeah, Bitcoin hit new all-time high. Why is this hot new altcoin Polkadot not moving? Right, so a lot of people gave up. A lot of people pivoted back into Bitcoin. And then you see what happened right after that, right? The huge run-up actually started. Another good example, Chainlink, right? So Chainlink, let's go back to right here, December 2020, Bitcoin hits new all-time high, December 2020. Chainlink is right here, trading at $12. And a lot of people were already big up on profits in Chainlink, right, throughout 2020. But you see what happened here. Bitcoin had a run-up. Chainlink actually had a drop-down from $13. It had a wick down to $9. So a lot of people actually capitulated on Chainlink. And then you see what happened after that. Chainlink went on another 5x run towards May 2021. Right? Again, very similar price pattern, very similar strategy to Polkadot chart. Another good example, Cardano. Again, Cardano was one of the hottest altcoins in early 2021. That's just the fact, right? Based on what happened in the charts. We're not talking about technology here. So look at this. Bitcoin hits new all-time high. Cardano, right at this point, was trading at 15 cents. And it took Cardano another, basically exactly right, another three to four weeks to break out of this range of around 20 cents. And then the insanity pretty much followed suit very quickly, right? Within 5 months, Cardano has hit another 15x. How crazy is that, right? Another similar scenario right here, right? On Binance. Binance coin itself, the OG. Bitcoin hits all-time high December 2020. Binance coin sitting at pretty much nowhere, right? $30. And then by late January, the run really started. And then Binance coin hits 15x from February to May. The same price chart you'll see throughout all of these charts we're gonna look at here for all the popular altcoins that popped in early 2021, right? Solana, another good example. Solana was nothing back in December 2021. It was trading at $2. Look at this. And shortly after Bitcoin hits all-time high, you see people actually capitulated on Solana as well. Solana dropped as low as $1.20. And this was one of the craziest entries if you had had it, right? Solana went on 200x run. Similarly, we see this on AVAX, right? AVAX just launched, right, before Bitcoin hit its new all-time high. Price wasn't doing much, right? AVAX was trading between $3 to around $5, right in this range. And then, what is this? 3 weeks after that, January 1st hits, and then AVAX goes on a 20x run within 2 months. And then if you count the later runs, that's a 50x run. That's crazy, right? Like every single chart we look at, right? Thorchain, I just have two more. We want to repeat, but here it is. Thorchain, pretty quiet, right? For a few weeks after Bitcoin hits new all-time high, and then New Year hits 20x run. Matic, here's the last one, I promise. Right, Matic, you see this huge consolidation, right, throughout 2019 and 2020, and then Bitcoin hits new all-time high right here. Matic doesn't do anything right away, right? You see Bitcoin starts to run, even already doubled, and then Matic finally starts to run, right? It breaks above 2 cents, 3 cents, and then the rest is history, right? We know how much Matic has done. This was like a 50x run, I believe. Yeah, even more. Yeah, like 80x run. So you see where I'm getting at right now. I don't really care what the reason is. You can say that, oh, like it's the cycle repeating. You can say it's, you know, the profits in Bitcoin finally flowing into altcoins. You can say that, you know, it's the timing and these strong projects really try to time their marketing events, their major updates, their product releases. They try to plan all of these events just after the Bitcoin new all-time high. No matter how you look at it, this has happened before. And there are, how many examples here? 9 examples of the strongest altcoin runs in 2021 happening within three weeks after Bitcoin hits a new all-time high. That is the real shocking part. So many coincidences all matching up together. So this is really what I want to take away for today's video to be. Now that Bitcoin is nearing its all-time high, it hasn't hit there yet, right? If you want to play the nuances, sure, right? The real Bitcoin all-time high is at $69,000. And we have hit $63,800, right? We're not there yet. How far away are we? Like 6% away. So it's not much, right? It's really not much further away. So this is why I would pay close attention to altcoin markets now. Think about what really lines up here. 3-4 weeks, maybe like 1.5 months, right? So within, let's say, 3 to 6 weeks period, we will likely have Bitcoin hitting a new all-time high. People seeing what happened the last time this has happened, the Bitcoin halving event finally taking over, and everyone starting to flood back with these two events coinciding and realizing, okay, this was really what kicked off the major altcoin rally, where we saw new large projects that are established enough actually making 20x runs. Things about to get crazy. And now is really the time to pay attention and to get positions in your favorite altcoins if you still haven't yet. I think you will even have some really good entries as we speak, right? Even just today, because let's zoom in here, right? Let's ignore some of these macro talk here. And let's really zoom into what's happening on Bitcoin's chart within the last 3 days, right? So when Bitcoin has ran from $50,000 to $63,000, what has happened to other altcoins? Look at Chainlink. Nothing has happened. Look at freaking Solana. Hasn't made a major breakout yet, right? It hasn't even touched its previous local high here that we made in December. And look at some of the newer altcoins, right? So altcoins that I'm personally quite bullish on for the next couple months, right? Based on strong catalyst events. For example, Matic, right? I'm actually very, very bullish on Matic right now because Matic has their ag layer coming up. It has their pole token migration coming up. A major ZK rollup season is coming up with Starknet finally launched, ZK Sync, Linea. A lot of ZK events are happening, and Matic is the only provider that has a token live in the market, and it has much superior tokenomics to everyone else. Look at what Matic is doing. Nothing, right? The price chart has done nothing. Like from January, it has gone up barely like 20%. It has completely underperformed Bitcoin, right? And then when you look at what has happened today, right? People are exiting these strong altcoins, right? When Bitcoin really saw its major run up here, Matic dropped. And when we look at some of the even newer altcoins that have been seeing like large amounts of trading volume on centralized exchanges, for example, some of the popular new altcoins like Mavia, right? This is one of the strongest price charts in the crypto gaming space, right? Look at what happened here. We saw a huge wick down when Bitcoin saw a wick up. What's really happening here? This is really showing the market's true colors here. So a lot of people are getting overly bullish on Bitcoin and trying to chase this run up with leverage. And that is why on today's run up, right, too many people are getting in way too early. And now that they see Bitcoin is hitting 60K, they really, really believe that it's going to run straight to like 70, 80K. And that's why we're seeing these really random wicks here, right? When Bitcoin hit 63,000 and then wick all the way down to 58. These kind of wicks are giving us huge entry opportunities in these strong altcoins in recent times, right? So I'll give you some clear targets of mine. Mavia, right? Right here, I think this is a really good entry opportunity. There is no reason for this to play out like this other than the fact that the leverage needs to be washed out, right? And when you look at how beautifully the chart has been performing before, this is a really, really strong entry opportunity here. Other similar charts, right? We have Pixel. What's happening here, right? I have been waiting and waiting for these 50 cent levels to be hit. And look at this. Hit just this morning, right? Right as Bitcoin has had this run up. Why would the strongest new listing altcoins see a dump? This is all driven by leverage. And as long as we know that, okay, this is purely a correction leading from the kind of Bitcoin euphoria in the short term, all of these altcoins no doubt will see a major comeback within 2 to 3 weeks time. Another good example here, Coty, look at this. This has been one of the strongest layer two projects that has had a major run up in February, right? So from 10 cents all the way run up to 27 cents. And you see, again, we're getting these kind of random ass wicks here. This morning, right? 15% wick down. People could have had amazing entries here at 20 cents. And in fact, I would still place my entries on Coty somewhere in this range, right? If we can get another wick down, as people aggressively try to chase Bitcoin right now and continue to get burned, I think we will get some really, really strong entries in these strongest performing altcoins, right? If you just map out the significant support levels. So Coty, anything between 19 and 20 cents, I think that's a killer buy. Some other good examples here. Look at Super, right? One of our channel's favorites, right? Huge, again, huge run up, touching all the way up $1.40. But what is this huge wick down here? $1.30, wick down to $1.12 for no reason, right? And I have had this entry range prepped for this whole time already. So significant resistance turn into support here. Here's some more price confluence bounced from the support. So as long as, you know, people try to continue to chase this Bitcoin pump with leverage, we should get some decent corrections on these strong altcoins. And this is what I would love to see, this kind of scenario for entry here on Super. Just a couple more here. Ribbon. Look at these large wicks. What is this? I am actually like hungry for these wicks. So we talked about this altcoin already in our last hidden gem portfolio video. I think we were trying to get an entry in these 40 to 43 cents range, right? These lower ranges. And now if I were to place an entry range now, it would be somewhere here, right? Where, let's see. Yep. So we have touched this range here, 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 and then bit of full consolidation within this range. And you see, what are these wicks, right? These wicks should not be happening. So if I just place some stink bits, let's say at 60 cents to 62 cents, I'm decently confident they can get hit with how much leverage is in the market right now. These will be killer buys on some of these strongest altcoins right now. Another good example, I am dying to get an entry on this, Arweave. I have followed Arweave for so long, right? For at this point, 1.5 years that we have covered it on our channel. I had taken it out of my portfolio from the beginning of the year. However, Arweave has just released a huge upgrade called AO, which is their next generation parallel computing platform that sits on top of their decentralized storage solution. So this was huge, actually a huge, huge upgrade. Basically puts Arweave back on the map and directly comparable to things like ICP, but much more sound technology because it's truly decentralized. And it looks like it has been 2 years in the making, and that's why Arweave has been so quiet. So nonetheless, right, with such a big surprise release, I am looking to get back into Arweave. And this is kind of the ideal scenario I'm hoping for. If we can get some wicks from Arweave back down into this range, let's say between $17 and $19, that will be a huge buy for me. Because look at how much this range matters, right? Dating all the way back to Arweave when it first launched, and then May 2022, so resistance levels tested three times from May to November 2022. And then finally here, this resistance level has been broken out of. So now it acts as support. If we can get a breakout retest entry range here, this will be killer. And I'm really, really hoping that the market euphoria, the market weird leverage within the next 2 to 3 weeks can give us some kind of entry like this. And it's totally possible. Looking at the kind of charts we saw on Chainlink, on Polkadot, on Matic, you know, on BNB, a lot of these coins, when Bitcoin made a new all-time high back in 2020, they saw a dip about 2 to 3 weeks after. That's what I'm really hoping for right here. And that's it. Those are some of the top altcoins that I'm watching to get in on an entry here within the next 2 to 3 weeks. And I really think this is the last time, really the last period. If you have strong picks in your fundamental analysis, this is the optimal time to get in. Because once Bitcoin clears this like high leverage period, high speculation period, when it first hits its previous all-time high, right? Once Bitcoin can establish itself, once the market agrees that, okay, previous all-time high has been cleared, people are going to start really, really flooding into the market and into altcoins as well. So take advantage of this high speculation period and try to get good entries in your favorite altcoins. I really do believe this is the last optimal time to get cheap prices. Say another good example, right? Thoughts on Caspa, another good example. I have a lot of them even on my watch list right here. So when you look at some of the charts here, Tau, Caspa, we have, what is it? Injective, Celestia, Say, these are all top targets that you can look to get an entry in, with this current like speculated period in Bitcoin with leverage. Why is that? Well, these are all fresh altcoins that have launched in the later stages of their last bear market or the early bull. And history has shown that these are likely to lead the market again. I didn't mention them specifically because like I think everyone already have them on their radar. But let's just show you a couple charts really quick here. Look at how Celestia has had this huge wick down also. 15% wick here. What is this, right? If something like this comes again and a little bit larger, like let's say $14, $13, that's going to be a godsend, right? Similar thing for Tau. Like Tau's kind of doing nothing while Bitcoin is pumping. You don't want to be like overly judging about what this is. If it's a market leader in early bull, it's going to lead into the later stages of the bull. Injective, here again, you see people are already trying to run this trade, right? Dropped from $40 with a wick down to $35, and it's already bouncing really quick. Caspa, oh my God, look at this. wick down from 18 cents to 14.5 cents. Oh, wow, look at how crazy of an entry that would have been. That matches the exact entry, like consolidation range here. Look at this. That's nuts. I can't believe this happened. So all in all, this is what I'm saying, right? If you are still looking at like entry into some of your favorite altcoins, whether that's like a small cap or even some of the market leaders, Injective, Caspa, BitTensor, you know, Celestia, whatever it is, place stink bids, right? Try to hunt cheap entries on them because they are happening. Caspa had an entry below 15 cents just today. How crazy is that? Okay, that's it. Before I go, couple things you should follow me on. So number one, make sure to follow me on X at virtualbacon0x. This is where I drop my quick alpha before I make them into these in-depth videos. You can find me on Twitter, tweeting all day with the link in the description. Virtualbacon0x is my handle. And if you are a trader and you want our in-depth analysis and trade setups, make sure to join our Discord with the link in the bio, or go to discord.gg/virtualbacon. We have a free VIP program. You just have to sign up to one of our partner exchanges. And we have my personal alpha, such as the Arweave AO launch. In fact, if you bet on these this event, people are already up like 25% if you caught this surprise drop early. Okay, that's it. That's everything I wanted to cover for today. Thank you guys again for joining, and I will see you on the next video and next live stream.